Face it, Tara. Robbie is just another loser.
Honey, don't say that. He's our son.
You mean your son? My son's supposed to be a football player, a baseball player, something athletic. That nerd in there is not my son.
Stop it. You never give him a break.
Hey, honey. Excited about your first day of school?
Yeah, I guess.
Matt, bring me another goddamn beer.
It's 7:45 in the morning, Dad.
Fine, then. Get that bitch of a mother of yours to bring me one.
She's not a bitch.
I got it, honey. Have a good day.
Where's my beer?
Stacey, are you looking forward to your first day?
Yes, the first day of my last year in high school. I cannot wait for college. I know you want me to go to state, Dad, but Kim wants me to go to Miami with her.
Miami? Why Miami? I mean, you don't even speak Spanish.
Miami is fine.
Love you, Aaron.
Now, what's wrong with state? I mean, after all, I'm an alumni there.
Bye, Dad. And don't forget, I'll be 18 soon, so I can do what I want. Hey, Mr. Alexander.
Ladies.
Thank you.
Catch you later. Ever that immature?
Well, at least they're at school and not out shooting someone out.
Don't even kid about that, Elena.
Good morning, Mr. Harmon.
Good morning, young ladies.
You must be Derek. Welcome to New World High, home of the Eagles.
Do you have your schedule?
Yes.
Well, that's a good start. I've got someone on the way to get you acclimated. I know it can be a little tough moving from a familiar neighborhood, familiar school, but life is much more about what you make of it than where you are. I know what it's like. I moved a lot as a kid. My dad, he was in the military.
Oh, that must be her. Come in.
Derek, this is Stacy. She'll show you around the campus and make sure you get to your first class.
Hi, Derek.
It's nice to meet you.
Wow, a senior with manners. That's different.
Well, you guys better get going. Mrs. Myers will give each of you a hall pass.
Don't worry, Mr. Harmon. I'll point him in the right direction.
I know you will.
It was nice meeting you, Mr. Harmon, and thanks for the advice.
Good luck, Derek.
We need a couple of hall passes.
You look nice today, Stacy.
Thanks. First days are so hectic. I changed twice before breakfast and once more after that.
How's your mom doing?
She's doing well.
Are you excited about your last year of school?
Yeah, I am.
Well, welcome to New World, Derek.
Thank you.
Do you have any more?
Yeah, I have.
Oh, hey, can I see your schedule?
It's here somewhere. Sorry. There it is.
It's alright. Haven't seen it all the time. Oh, calculus. Mr. Kearns. That's right here. He's one of the good ones.
That's good to know.
Hey, you're in Ms. King's fourth period sociology class. So am I. You're really lucking out on your teachers.
Well, my good luck started back in Mr. Harmon's office.
Well, I hope you like it here. See you in fourth period.
Thanks.
Robbie.
Kim. You're in drama class.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's great. I never would have picked you for an insecure, narcissistic actor.
Somehow I'm not surprised to see you here.
Thank you so much. How long have you been acting?
On and off, my whole life. Just helps with the stress.
I know what you mean. We're all just actors on the big stage of life, right? Acting helps me explore new worlds and expand my universe. You okay?
Oh, yeah, just got lost in your universe. Never really found a place in mind. So, what do you think we're doing in here today?
Probably watching a movie. Got a date?
No. All alone.
Well, there's a free seat next to me.
Has anyone heard about a group called the Freemasons? Derek, right?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Supposedly, they're a fraternal organization that arose from obscure origins around the world. The various forms often include moral and metaphysical ideals, which, in most cases, constitutes declaration and belief of a supreme being. Freemasonry has also been described as a system of morality, veiled in allegory and shrouded by symbols.
Derek, I'm impressed. How did you know so much about the Freemasons?
Internet.
Jeez, good work. Keep it up.
Thanks.
Michael's such a jerk.
No kidding.
Looks like you're finding your way around here, okay?
Yeah, thanks. I only got lost once.
This is Derek. He's new. Derek, this is Matt. All right, class, come on, quiet down. Let's get started.
What?
All right, man, you're in.
Me?
Yes, you dumbass. Let's go.
Michael, watch your mouth, would you?
Sorry, coach. My bad.
You ever played before?
Yes. No.
You never played basketball before. Alright. It's alright, come here. It's alright. Don't worry about Michael, it tends to be an ass, alright? Just go out there and have fun. It'll be alright, okay? Alright, come on, let's go.
It seems I'm on a mission looking for what I've been missing. Never leak escaping snakes, the haters in the crooked system. Watch for them, stop looking, listen, you could miss them. They could be plotting on you and you could be running with them. However, I've been in it, living with it for a minute. I'm conditioned, so I never let it get me off my pivot. Got opposition dripping, cause I'm playing my position. When they caught me slipping, and it's obvious they didn't. Yes, I'm still standing, plotting and planning to take over the game, if not the whole planet. To every hater hated and every fan demanded, I'm withstanding, giving you anthem after anthem. And they don't make a
get the hell out of my way.
Maybe hard to market, but the streets will endorse them. It ain't all champagne and falling for them. This is my blood, sweat, my tears, I'm all in.
In the corner. In the corner. My sweat, my tears, my life right now, right here. In the corner.
I put it all on the line, I'm riding. My time is near.
Oh, man. Did you get that from playing?
Yeah. Ugh.
Michael takes sports seriously. Just like my dad.
Your dad likes sports?
He's obsessed with them. Which is why he wants me to like them.
So what, you don't? It's not that I don't like them, it's just not good at them. It's ironic. You don't want to play sports, and your dad wants you to. I love to play sports, and my dad doesn't want me to.
Why not?
Matt, what are you doing? Let's go.
Later, buddy.
Derek, dinner's ready.
I'm not hungry. I'll get some later.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I had a sandwich after school.
Well, I'll leave you a plate on the stove.
That's fine.
Hey, honey, how was practice?
It was good. I'm exhausted.
Well, just grab yourself a bowl of dinner and relax, okay?
You think a guy could get some fucking food in his own house?
I'll be right there.
Mom.
Not now, Matt.
Then when?
Robbie, how was school today?
It was okay. I even played basketball.
How was it?
It was okay, I guess.
Okay? Just okay?
Yeah.
Robbie, that isn't good enough.
Here we go.
Frank, please. Not tonight.
Robbie, success is a pattern. Successful habits form a successful pattern. Once you start getting used to an okay pattern, you'll never know what true success really is. Can you understand that?
Your dad just wants you to be the best you can be.
But what if my best is something else? What if it has nothing to do with sports?
That would be fine when you get older. Team sports, especially in high school, teach you the things that you'll need to know later in life. They teach you about working with other people and knowing where your place is on a team. Robbie, you can't just get up and walk away from reality when you feel like it.
Whose reality, Dad? Mine or yours?
What's that supposed to mean?
I wonder if there's a place in the universe for me.
Good night, sweetheart.
Good night, Dad.
Oh, by the way, honey, you can go to college wherever you want, as long as you go somewhere.
So, if social upheaval has led to positive change in our past, when has it unleashed negative forces? Disrespect for the rule of law, repression, lack of common human decency, chaos. It could have happened in the past, or it could be happening right now. It could be changing the course of history halfway around the world, or in your own personal backyard. Your project is to prepare a report on the positive or negative impact social upheaval has had or is having on our country, our world, or even your own personal lives. Now, I'm giving you a lot of leeway here, guys, so just choose the topic that most interests you. And you'll be working in teams of four. I've already made it easy for you and broken your teams up, based primarily on seat location, but of course with an overall thought towards participation and stimulation. Any questions so far? Since this project will have a significant impact on your grade, I'm going to give you until December 5th to do your research and prepare your report. Now, on that day, I expect you all to be here, and as a group, you will present your project in the form of an oral report. Right now, though, I would like you just to look at the board, check out who your teammates are, and then break off into your respective groups. You know, just say hi to each other, toss around a couple of ideas, because I'm only giving you 1 week to pick a topic.
I don't know any of these people.
Great. I'm teamed with Matt.
What's wrong with that?
You know, you think something's over with someone, then you get put in an uncomfortable situation with said person. And before you know it, you're right back where you started.
And the problem with that is?
The problem with that is I don't want to go back there again. I mean, it's okay to look over your shoulder at the past once in a while. But you don't want to stare at it, or go back to it.
Well, what if the past is better than the future?
Then everything's meaningless anyway. Anybody got any ideas?
It can be good or bad, right?
As long as it had an impact.
You all are gonna think I'm weird, but I have an idea.
The floor's yours. Just make it good. I need a good grade on this.
Same here.
What's your plan? Remember a couple years ago, three kids stormed into a high school and started blasting away?
Yeah, that was sick. What was it, like
25 people were killed?
29 to be exact. One of them was a close friend of mine.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I don't know if you ever really get over something like that. I've thought about it. Too much, actually. Talk about something having an impact. You try to figure it out, but no matter how hard you try and no matter how many ways you look at it, it just doesn't make sense.
So, are you suggesting that we recreate a school massacre? Blow up the school, maybe?
Robbie, don't even say that.
Yeah, Robbie, get real. That wasn't what you meant, right?
No, I don't look that nuts, do I? I'm talking about doing a project on the people who did the shootings. What was going through their heads, and how screwed up were their lives to even consider doing something like that?
It would be dramatic.
I don't know. It sounds like a horror movie or something.
It was horrible. And it definitely had an impact.
She's got a point. Does anyone have a better idea?
What would we call it?
How about HavoK? High School HavoK.
If you guys like it, I'm in.
How are you guys doing over here?
Really good, Ms. King.
Excellent. Have you guys decided on a topic yet?
We've got something in mind.
Good, because I'm expecting a really interesting report from you four.
Oh, don't worry. It'll be killer.
Bothered. Girl troubles?
Nah, there's no girl trouble.
It's gotta be your dad then.
Yeah. Fuck it. Just take it out on the mat.
You're good and all, you know, but it's only practice.
Thank you.
Robbie?
Yes, Mom?
You know, it's not too early to start making those college applications.
I know. I'm already taking care of it.
I just want to make sure you get into a good engineering school. I know that's what you love to do. And I know you don't want to get stuck here going to community college.
Okay. But what about Dad?
Don't worry about Dad. I'll take care of that. You just focus on this stuff.
Stanford.
What's that?
Stanford. The robot's name is Stanford.
Good night, sweetie.
Good night, Mom.
Robbie named that robot he's working on. Can you believe it?
It's Robbie. Of course I can believe it. What'd he name the damn thing anyway?
Stanford.
Stanford?
Stanford.
Stanford. What are we gonna do?
Ballerina. You make me sick.
It's all you. Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Great tonight. Give yourself a hand, all right? Yeah. Great night tonight, gentlemen. Look, I'm especially proud of you guys for leaving it all on the mat tonight, okay? Because we got a very special guest with us this evening, Principal Harmon. Your man, come on, yeah.
Hey, guys, that was a great match tonight. And if in case you didn't hear all the noise from the crowd, you made everybody at New World High really proud tonight. You wrestled like true champions.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, can we wrestle good enough to get a day off next week? Come on, Coach.
Yeah, one day. Come on, Coach.
Just one day. Okay, everybody's got one day off from practice, okay? Yeah. Hey, but that means practice only, okay? You still gotta go to school every day, you hear me?
Yeah, I'm sorry, but I agree with the coach. But I wanna add one more thing. With all the negative stuff you read about these days, it's really refreshing to be associated with individuals, students like you, that put such a positive shine on our school and our community. For everyone in New World and myself, thanks, guys.
Yeah. Way to go, guys, way to go.
Straighten up. You have to be strong for them. Hi, baby.
hurt. A little, but mommy's gonna be okay. Can't God just make the pain go away? I love you. I love you too.
Jocelyn, mommy's got to rest now. Let Stacey talk to her.
Come on, don't let tears ruin that pretty face.
It's not fair.
You're gonna be 18 soon. You've had to grow up too quick. But you've grown into a beautiful young woman. You have to be strong for your father and your sister.
I need you.
I love you, Stacey.
I love you too.
For Dad or Jocelyn, I would much rather be with you. I'm just feeling kind of empty right now. After my mom died, I never felt like I'd get close to anyone again. And then you come along. And now you're gone. I'm having a little trouble with the big plan here. Any advice? Rest easy. And for all the times I miss saying it, I love you.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Don't worry about it. It's just a flower.
No, it's your flower.
Thanks.
Hi.
Hi. Is Derek here?
Stacey, right?
That's me.
Come on in. They're in the garage. They're in here.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Finally, you made it.
Sorry, I got lost.
Don't worry about it. We all get a little lost once in a while.
Matt, how are your applications coming along?
I've listened to a few. But I don't know. I gotta straighten some stuff out at home first. I do know if I'm gonna get into any of these colleges, we're gonna have to get a good grade on this, guys.
It's what we're here for.
I can't believe your parents give you this whole garage to yourself.
Honestly, my parents don't care what I do. I could be in here starting a revolution or building a rocket. Shit, I could be plotting a school massacre and they wouldn't have a clue. They're so disconnected.
I'd kill for this kind of peace.
I can't say my parents are disconnected. Although my dad's never really accepted me for who I am, just who I'm not.
Accepted you? But you're like
A genius.
Yeah, well, he's always wanted me to go to college and be some kind of sports star.
Well, first my real mom dies, and then when I finally get close to my stepmom, she was taken away from me. I feel like my whole life has been turned upside down. And my dad, I think he's doing drugs, heavy drugs. I feel like my life couldn't get any worse. It's just not fair.
No, it's not. Life can be a toilet bowl. Sometimes you just have to keep flushing until the shit disappears.
I wish my dad would disappear.
That's pretty harsh.
It's the truth. I wish someone or something would just make him be gone. Turn him into dust and blow him away.
Like a wish granted by a genie.
Yeah, like a genie in a fucking bottle. You know where I can find one of those?
Well, I don't know about the genie turning him into dust part, but he can certainly be blown away.
My mom said he was a different person before he went off to war. But he came back all changed. Now he hates everything and everybody.
You don't have to tell us, Matt. It's okay.
He's an ex-Marine drunk. He beats my mom all the time, and when I try to stop him, he threatens to kill us both. I've grown to hate him. I hate going home. The only reason I go home is to see if my mom's okay. I wish he would have died in that war. At least then I wouldn't be thinking about killing him so much right now.
So why don't you?
So why don't I what?
Kill him.
Come in.
Good morning, Miss King.
Hey, how are you?
Fine, thank you.
Good.
Please have a seat.
Thank you.
Ms. King, I couldn't help but be a little curious about some research that's being done in one of your classes. High school tragedies?
Well, to be honest, I'm pretty curious about that one myself.
Which students are in that group?
Matt Reynolds, Stacey Clark, Robbie Solomon, and Derek Freeman.
Derek? He's one of our new students.
Yes.
How's he adjusting?
He seems to be doing fine. He's not giving me any problems. He's one of those students that we all want in our classroom. Just quiet, attentive, and natural leader.
And Robbie?
Pretty much the same. He keeps up with everyone. He's a pretty smart kid. I'm actually really looking forward to this interesting project.
How's Stacy doing? You know, losing a parent is never easy, especially at her age.
As well as can be expected, at least in my class. She's a little withdrawn, but nothing too extreme. I actually think that this group activity is really good for her right now. Gives her something else to think about.
How's Matt doing? You know, when he puts his mind to it, he is a proven competitor and a winner.
I agree. Good of you to notice the athletic presence in the group, Sam. We all know how you feel about Matt, but I must admit, he does bring a certain strength to the group.
Well, yes, I like Matt, but I like all of my students. But it goes a little bit farther than that. I've known him a long time. I used to hang out with his dad before, well, let's just say he's had to adjust. The war changed his father, but not in a good way. I have a few talks with him about home life, but I think that dealing with it has given him a lot of fortitude. His head screwed on pretty tight.
I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear any more shit from them.
Hey, all right.
I put my heart and money to put it to do what? Not to put up with this shit. I'm going to put it through the wall next time. And you too!
It's enough! What the hell's wrong with you?
What's wrong with me? That no good bitch raising a voice at me. And you.
Yeah? What about me?
You're just as worthless. Both of you never respected me. Hell, you don't even know the value of a father!
How do you measure the value of a father when all you do is sit around, get drunk, and beat your wife?
That's it.
That's it!
You want to beat a man around here, huh?
Stop it! Stop it! Matt! John! Stop it! Stop it!
Oh!
I'm the man of this house. Don't you forget it!
Scared the shit out of us.
Oh my god, Matt, your eye, what happened?
My dad and I got into it last night. Don't worry about it.
Another good father-son talk, huh?
Glenn, my dad doesn't talk to me like that.
Is that real?
Of course it's real.
You ever used it?
No.
Does your dad know you have it?
Of course not. He'd kill me.
Why are you laughing? This is serious, Matt.
So, why'd you bring this?
I don't know. He's got a whole bunch of that stuff in his shed.
Your dad keeps this and a bunch of others in your backyard?
I told you he's nuts. He's got a whole bunch of shit. I don't even know how he got it all back there without the cops finding out. It's like they turn their head when an ex-military type collects all this shit.
How about ammunition?
Ammo? He's got a whole storage cabinet full.
You know, I've heard some pretty harsh stuff out of you guys since school started. And if you ask me, none of you deserve it. Call me crazy, but I have an idea. We all want to make an impact with this school massacre project, right? So, what would be the ultimate report? What could we really do to blow them away? What if the kids behind these school massacres had it right? What if it's all just useless? The education, the good life, the facade of happiness. We all know it's just an illusion. It's all bullshit. I mean, who really gives a fuck about what we do? No one. No one gives a shit. Our families certainly don't.
He's right. I feel more and more like a lemming in this fucked up world every day.
What's a lemming?
You don't know what a lemming is?
No. Why should I?
Well, let's just say you don't want to be one. They're hairy little rodents that can't think for themselves. They play follow the leader and trudge mindlessly for miles before jumping headlong over a cliff into the sea and drown. Not one of them stops to think, wait a minute, this is stupid. Maybe I should take another route.
Really?
Yeah, Stace. Being a lemming sucks.
I say we learn as much about these school massacres as we can. What they did right and what they did wrong. Then we get back at every last son of a bitch that's fucked with us.
Kill them all?
Yeah. Only we'll walk away.
Are you guys serious? Matt, can I talk to you for a second?
Sure.
In private? Tell me I'm not hearing this. I may be depressed, but I'm not crazy. Do you hear yourself? You guys are talking about killing people.
Yeah. I guess we are.
Ms. Myers?
Yes.
Could you please get me the absentee reports for the last 2 months?
For the entire school?
No, just the senior class.
Sure, I'll have it on your desk before you get settled.
Wish I could train my wife like I've trained you.
It's called professionalism.
So I'd have to pay her?
Oh yes, it works for me.
Mr. Harmon?
Yes?
It's the superintendent.
I'll take it in my office.
Hello.
Morning, Sam. Stu Wilson.
This should be an interesting day. My first call, and it's the superintendent. How you doing, Stu?
I can't complain. How are things in New World?
Well, we're doing our best to live up to our name.
Speaking of that, can I be
expecting some good news in your report next month?
Well, unless the Earth stops rotating, I think we'll both be happy.
That's why I like to call you first thing in the morning, Sam. You always start my day out on a positive note. And now the number one question. Will I be seeing you at the holiday party?
Well, you know I wouldn't miss that. I look forward to seeing you and Helen there. I'll talk to you soon.
Okay, Sam.
Here's an example of a one-to-one function. Does everybody have that? I don't want to hear about this tomorrow in class if you don't have it.
To tomorrow.
I'll pay you double, okay?
I just need something tonight.
All right, good. Look, I'll come to you. Tell me where you're at. All right, I'll be right there.
In here?
All right, everybody, you've got the last 10 minutes of class to break off into your groups. I'm going to come around, ask a couple of questions, and then we'll go from there. So go ahead and break them off.
What are we gonna tell her?
Don't worry.
Don't worry. She's on her way over here right now.
Just shut up, Robbie. How's everything going on over here, guys?
Just fine. We really learned a lot.
Miss King, if I may.
Please.
We really wanted to get inside the families to bring out the true pain behind the students who did these awful things. Truth is, in most cases, nobody ever saw it coming.
Interesting. Seems like you guys have really been doing your research. I like it.
Well, we're doing our best to bring it all together.
Good, good. Continue, you guys. Oh, excuse me. Miss King?
Stacey. Please have a seat. Stacey, I was informed of some upsetting news.
Upsetting news about what? Who?
Your father. A police officer driving through Glendale Park last night found him in his car. He was dead.
Dead? My father dead?
It was a drug overdose. Stacey, drink a little.
Dead. My whole world is dead. Did you see that? Right between the eyes.
Nice shot. Knew you were a natural.
I'm eastbound on 186, about a mile out of Gappettsville. I've got an abandoned car on the side of the road I'm gonna go check out. Dispatch. I've got shot fired. I'm requesting backup right now.
Put your guns on the ground. Now. Carefully.
Sorry, officer. We didn't see anyone here, so we thought it would be okay.
That's a lot of firepower for you guys to be having, and you look a little bit too young to have it. Now, I want to see some IDs, and I want to see some permits now.
Permits, ID? Told you guys we should have brought that stuff. Sorry, officer. It seems that nobody remembered to bring the permits.
What are you doing all the way out here anyway?
We're doing research for a school project.
A school project?
Yes, sir.
Your school project involves shooting at targets that look like people.
Someone's bad attempt at humor, officer. A friend gave them to us. We couldn't get any real targets.
What's your name, son?
Derek Freeman.
And you?
Robbie Solomon.
Stacey Clark.
Matt Reynolds.
Matt Reynolds. Matt Reynolds, where do I know that name from? Oh, you're the wrestler out of New World High. Matter of fact, don't you guys have a big match coming up?
Yes, sir. State championship.
Yeah. You guys are pretty good. The rest of you go to New World High?
Yes, sir. Like Derek said, we're doing a school project together.
I'll tell you what, that's a crazy project. And even if I give you the benefit of the doubt here, you're still breaking the law. Your research should have included gun laws. So I'm going to have to confiscate all these weapons until the results of the investigation determine exactly what you're doing with these guns.
You'll have to tell our parents. Mine will be really disappointed. They're always lecturing me about guns.
I'm afraid so, son. I have no choice.
33 dispatch.
This is 33 dispatch. Go ahead.
What's your status out there, Captain?
I've got the situation under control. You can cancel backup. I've got some juvenile time.
Detective Mondo.
You got something?
Yeah, check it out. Looks like a keychain.
A keychain? That's pretty careless.
Yeah, they must have been in a big hurry. Either that or they were scared shitless, one of the two.
Or both. One thing's for sure, they're definitely not professionals, and there was more than one shooter.
Looks like we got three or four sets of footprints to go along with Sheriff Murphy's.
Good. We got tire markings, shell casings, footprints, and now a keychain.
And an engraving.
You know what I hate worse than a fucking psycho, Pete? Is a bunch of fucking psychos. Come on, let's get back to headquarters.
Unbelievable. How anyone can just kill a police officer. And they still don't have any suspects. And that the only piece of evidence is a keychain from New World High School.
Derek, your father and I worry about you. We just want to make sure that you're safe and not hanging out with the wrong people.
Don't worry, Mom. My friends would do anything for me. Anything.
That's good to know, honey.
Excuse me. Hello, you got enough for everybody over here?
Good morning. May I help you?
Good morning, young lady. I'm Detective Mondo. This is Detective Crenshaw. Would you please tell Mr. Harmon we'd like to speak to him?
Do you mean Principal Harmon?
Yes, Principal Harmon.
Good morning, gentlemen. How can I help you?
They're detectives. They want to speak with Principal Harmon.
Okay, thanks, Carly. I'll take it from here. You can go back to what you're doing, Carly. Detectives, can you please follow me?
Thank you.
Mr. Harmon, I have two detectives here to see you. I'm sorry, gentlemen, I didn't get your names.
I'm Detective Mondo. This is Detective Crenshaw.
Hello, detectives. I think I know why you're here.
Then you've seen the news.
Unfortunately, yes. Have you any more information about the crime?
You mean the murder? I know it's a little tough to say if you're not used to it, but unfortunately, in our line of work, it comes with the territory.
Please, sit down.
No, thank you. I'll stand.
Did you really find a New World keychain?
I'm afraid we did.
We also found tire tracks, shell casings, footprints. We should have results within 48 hours.
It seems you have a lot to go on.
It's a good start. Whoever did this didn't plan it. They were very sloppy, inexperienced.
They?
Well, all indications point to several different people being involved.
Do you really think it was someone at New World High?
We have to consider all possibilities.
Excuse me, I have to call Mrs. Myers.
Yes, sir. I'll be right in.
Ms. Myers, do you know who received New World keychains?
Yes, I believe it was given to the faculty and the entire senior class at the recent pep rally.
Would you be able to give us a list of those people?
Yeah, it should just take a moment.
Thank you. And thank you, Principal Harmon, for your time. Here's my card. If you come across anything, please feel free to give me a call.
I will. And if you discover anything that involves New World High, please let me know. I want to stay on top of this as well.
Absolutely. Come on, Cookie, let's go.
Excuse me, fellas.
No problem, Detective.
Very impressive, Robbie. And here I thought you spent all your free time jacking off.
Yeah, right. Check this out. This right here is enough to take out the entire gym.
That's fucking sick.
I know.
Okay, guys. This is our last organizational night before Havoc hits. We need to make sure all our bases are covered. Matt, everything ready?
It's locked and loaded. Nobody even knows they're missing.
Excellent. Okay, one more piece of business. Robbie, tomorrow night is key.
You can't be serious. It's a class project.
We finished our homework, we did all our research, and all that's left is to present the project.
The project's not due till tomorrow. Why are you in the electrical room tonight?
Just trying to get into character.
What are you talking about?
Look, Kim, you're an actress. You know that we all have our roles to play, and sometimes you're a good guy, and sometimes you're a bad guy. Well, I take my roles very seriously. You should know that.
Whatever you're doing, you can stop it right now. The play can be over.
Hey,
Answer the phone. Answer the freaking phone.
Robbie, what are you doing? Taking a fucking nap? Get in the car.
There's my sweet young thing. Hey, baby. Come to dance.
Mr. Zero Sings. That's what Mr. Zero Sings.
Thanks for letting me come by. I just couldn't stay in that house.
Sorry, I took it easy.
Did you ever think we'd be doing something like this?
Does anybody ever really think of anything these days?
I don't know. I'm just scared. I mean, are we really that insane?
Us and everybody else, Stace.
You alright? You've been acting a little weird lately.
Better now?
I didn't realize how serious you guys were about Havoc. For a minute tonight, I actually thought you were planning to go through with it.
Yeah, I was starting to believe that too. Can you imagine me storming a school with real guns, ammunition, and explosives? That is another universe, Kim.
Strange.
I know. I was born that way.
Not you. That of the whole universe. You and I would be right here. Right now.
It's the most comfortable place I've ever been.
See you later.
Say, Dad, What kind of gun did you say this was anyway?
It's a Beretta, goddammit. Put that fucking thing down before you hurt somebody.
Yeah. You're right.
Hello? Security? The phone's not working. Okay, thank you. Carly?
Yes, Miss Myers?
Can you give this to everyone? Just make sure everyone gets one of these.
Have a good day.
Bye-bye.
Sure.
Thanks.
Could you get a bigger bowl?
If that mother of yours would wash the fucking dishes. And just what in the hell are you doing with that?
Oh, didn't I tell you? I took up a new sport. Just like you wanted me to. Target shooting.
You know, I think I might have a knack for this.
Lightning struck the daybreak, leaving anger in the air. Lightning struck at daybreak, I felt anger in the air.
One less asshole in the world.
Feel better?
Yeah.
Where's Derek?
I don't know. I tried calling him 6 times. He won't pick up the phone.
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
I tried too. Maybe something happened.
What could have happened, huh?
I don't know.
We're not going without him.
He's the reason we're here in the first place.
We have to, Matt. I have nothing else left.
Me either. I've gone way too far to go back, so have you. Stacey and I are doing this with or without Derek.
Fucking Derek.
Matt, are you with us or not? We don't want you screwing this up.
Matt!
Fuck it. Robbie's right. We've passed the point of no return. With or without Derek, we've got to do this. Give me your phone one more time, and I'm going to try to get a hold of him.
Okay. Now, if we all just stick to the plan, be sure to be some major havoc.
Mondo, take a look at this.
When did this come in?
Forensics, just send it over.
Fuck, get Principal Harmon on the phone right away. Listen, grab Stacey Clark's address, meet me in the car, Crenshaw, let's go. Jump in the pool and soak your head.
Of human behavior, how can we somehow bring that to the present and... Kim? Kim, are we boring you?
What?
Are we boring you?
No, I just thought I saw Matt, Stacey, and Robbie outside.
Resume in a moment, class. Just hang tight for a second.
Did anybody have any questions about the assignment last night? All right, class. Just settle down, stay in your seats. Everything's gonna be okay. I'm just gonna go check out what's going on. Nobody leave.
Thank you.
Hey, you.
Who, me?
Yeah, you. Dumbass. Oh, you're free to go.
Yes.
Principal Harmon, this is Detective Monk. Listen, I heard what's going on over there. We're on our way. Do you know who the shooters are?
Yeah, I think they're three of our students.
Is Stacey Clark one of them?
I think so. And if I'm right, the other two are Robbie Solomon and Matt Reynolds.
Listen, we're pulling up right now. Keep your cell phone on. You're going to be our inside contact.
Still trust me, Matt. Just put the guns down so we can talk about this.
Wanna talk, huh?
Right.
Let's talk.
Okay.
Let's talk.
What do you wanna talk about?
I wanna talk about?
Yeah.
Amanda Higgins? Huh?
Man, that was a mistake.
She was 15!
Mistake.
15, you sick fuck!
Oh, man. No, don't do this to me. Please don't. I'd beg you, don't do this to me. It was a mistake.
It was a mistake?
Don't, Matt. Come on, please, Matt. Don't do this to me.
Well, guess what?
Please, no.
Principal Harmon, this isn't a mistake.
No.
Thank you.
Lisa. Did you guys see this thing?
Started. You played us like lemmings.
I guess there really isn't a place in the universe for me.
Down here at New World High, the authorities are still securing the building and paramedics are trying to assist the injured as quickly as possible. The most recent report is 31 dead, including 3 shooters and 16 injured. This is a sad day for Gabbettsville.
You're really lucky not on any teachers.
Well, my good luck started back in Mr. Harmon's office.
I don't look that nuts, do I?
We all get a little lost once in a while. We're doing research for a school project.
Killing.
You guys are talking about killing people.
Yeah.
My friends would do anything for me. Anything. Truth is, in most cases, nobody ever saw it coming.